due east from our nation's capital at FedEx Field in Landover, Maryland. Tonight, we'll have the final two games of this kickoff weekend, and we begin with a great one here between the Pittsburgh Steelers and the Washington Redskins. And not a bad return here. He gets it out to the 25-yard line. So out come the Steelers now for their first drive. They'll be led out by their fifth-year quarterback out of Boise State. It's the lefty, Kellen Moore.
An absolutely incredible college career. Lost three games as a starting quarterback by a total of 5 points. Began in Detroit in the NFL, and what a game he had last year against the Jets. Over 400 yards passing and 3 touchdowns.
And his first pass here is going to fall incomplete. Antonio Brown, the intended receiver, and it's second down. He's going to find his running back. It's complete. Give him 7 on the play, and that'll bring up a third down.
I like it. I like it. I like it. Get everyone involved in the passing game, and you know you can create those great mismatches throwing it to your guys out of the backfield.
And on the first drive, that can also help establish some rhythm, right?
I think so. It gets everyone involved. They feel like they're part of it and really gets them amped up as they go forward.
And he's got the first before he's brought down at the 39-yard line.
Would it be safe to say that as precise as routes are supposed to be run in the NFL, maybe they're not quite as precise in college ball?
That's accurate, yeah.
And I think we saw a college route in the NFL there. Just find the soft spot, find the dead zone, and find the first down. And that's what he just did.
And he's going to get this all the way down inside the 35. And they get 28 yards on that one. And it'll give the Steelers a first down.
It's funny, partner. Le'Veon Bell, when he came out of Michigan State, when I go back and look at my analysis of him and what my grades were for him, thought he was a big-time player, great potential, but I didn't know we were going to get this player. I was used to a big, solid, thick running back, but now I've got a full package, a guy who can do everything, as we just saw there, including breaking tackles.
But at the time, second-round pick in 2013, some people probably wishing they'd taken him in the first.
Well, coaches always talk about finding balance on offense. I don't think you can get much more balance than this. Big time run, big time pass.
A 1-2 combination looked pretty good.
How about that? Let's see if they can continue to take that kind of a punch, though.
Now a first down carry by Bell. Call it a gain of 4 on first, and that'll make it second down. And here comes play number 6 on this drive. More now. And the hit jarred loose. It's incomplete.
On any passes in the middle of the field, anyone who's going after the football is going to be conscious that it's probably going to be contested and often physically. Sometimes that leads to drops.
They'll look to throw. Got his man. It's caught for a Steelers touchdown. Marcus Wheaton, a 12-yard touchdown grab. And the Steelers take the ball down the field and score on their opening drive. And he's a little bit on the shorter side as a receiver. Maybe sometimes for the defense, tough to find the little guys, right?
Yeah, sometimes they get lost in the traffic, but usually what it means is that rather than just winning with height or even speed, they use their quickness to find a way to get open.
Well, tall, short, wide, skinny, whatever, there it results in a touchdown. Set now to kick this one away, and off it goes. And this will be a touchback, so a first chance here in week one to see the ball be brought out with the new rule to the 25-yard line. Now the Redskins starter here in 2016. It's Matt Jones. That's going to go as a loss of 2, and it'll be second down.
What we did to Marcus Ware's games in Dallas, didn't we spend most of the time talking about him rushing the passer?
We did, and how about now?
Oh, boy, he's expanded his game in a big way. Really does a great job in the run game now, using his length, using his leverage to hold the point of attack. and make plays as we just saw there.
And he's just going to get rid of this thing to no one here. He throws it away, and now it's third. Incomplete pass on second down. Let's see what the offense draws up here on third.
Let's go.
Davis now. And he drops this off to Thompson, complete. And he's got the first down yardage before he's brought down at the 42. The play goes for 19 yards, gives him a new set of downs.
So many times you hear today's NFL described as a space game. Get your best players into space with the football in their hands. That's why sometimes you swing it out to your runner, get him out in the flat, and let him have a chance to make people miss an open field.
Jordan Reed was the intended target, and now it's second down. He was looking for Jamison Crowder there, and it's third down.
When you see passes knocked down by those guys I call the frustrated fullbacks, the linebackers, you know that in their zone coverage, they were able to drop, see the ball thrown, and react to it very quickly.
Green, 39.
Off the play fake, he'll look to throw. Jordan Reed has it, and out of bounds on the other side of midfield across the 45. And the offense lining up first and 10.
Well, the advantage has certainly shifted to the defense as we began that third down play, and they found a way to foil it and pick up a first down.
Third time's a charm, right? Two incompletions. Had to have it on third, and they got it.
Yeah, they stuck with it, weren't daunted at all, and picked it up.
So incomplete on first. Let's see what second down has in store. Jones, and he's going to fight his way forward here for a modest gain. It'll be a pickup of five, and that leaves him with five more. Third and five now. And there, Matt Jones, the ball carrier. Last year, only 3.4 yards per carry. Did have some explosive plays, though, in the passing game.
And they think that they're going to get him in the running game from him now as well, because the volume of carries for him will increase.
Caught on the right side, Reed. And they get 10 yards there and convert on third.
Brandon, from our time in college football, where receivers weren't running the traditional NFL route tree, one thing they did learn, find open areas, find soft spots, and set up and catch the ball. And I think we just saw that there.
Yeah, we saw that indeed, picking up the first. There's a first NFL catch for Josh Doxson. Give him nine on the play, and that'll make it second and short. Well, just play after play after play on this long drive for the offense. And he's had great protection back there to throw, really been able to survey from the pocket.
That means the jersey stays clean, so the dry cleaning bill, that's reduced. It also means the trainer doesn't have to deal with him because he's not getting hit. Also means that he's able to find targets downfield at his leisure. That allows him to be really accurate. The Steelers insert their nickel defense on third down.
Yeah, they add a DB. They'll set up to throw. This is caught by Jackson. Call it a gain of seven, and it gets him a new set of downs. And the defense with their backs against the wall a little bit here as the offense is in the red zone. Well, they've had a great, impressive drive going here, and that pickup ensures the drive continues.
And not only do you continue the drive, which is demoralizing for the guys on the defense side of the ball right now, but you make your own defense happy. They're able to get a little more rest over on the sidelines while this one continues downfield.
Ooh, long drive. The defense just cannot seem to catch a break and get off the field. And second and 10, he'll look to throw again. Can't find anyone open. And he is into the end zone for a Washington touchdown. Deshaun Jackson from 13 yards out. And the Redskins are an extra point away from tying this thing up. That's an old-fashioned death march there, partner. Took them a lot of plays, but hey, they did the job.
And the defense always preaches getting off the field, making a play, and turning it back over to their own offense. Unable to do so. A long, sustained drive by the offense.
So a tie ball game here as the kick's away. This one taken just inside the 10. Oh, nice spin.
Oh, that brought back bad memories.
And nice work on the return as they'll start their drive just past the 30-yard line. The Steelers' offense now, they head back onto the field. And that recipe on their last drive that resulted in a touchdown looked pretty good, so they'll be hoping to do that once more.
It takes me back to when we sat with the offensive coordinator and the head coach. They felt pretty good about their game plan and thought there were some holes in the defense, and they exploited them the last time out. Let's see if they can come back and put together a similar drive.
And we'll see if they can do just that. More now. This is Bell on the dump off. And he'll be out of bounds after getting this one across the 40. So we played a quarter here on the opening Monday night of the new season. 7-all is the score. We'll head back to FedEx. Back with Charles Davis, Brandon Gaudin. It's Steeler football to begin quarter number two. And they've got it here with a first down. One receiver left, three to the right. Now Moore. And this is caught by Martavis Bryant. And he's brought down after a good game. It's a gain of 20 that time. And the Steelers are going to have a first down. They come out five wide, three of them to the right side. On first down, he'll drop to throw. Firing quickly here, and that's complete. And he'll be brought down at the 27-yard line. It's a gain of 9 yards. And it'll be second and about a yard to go for the first. They'll stick with the passing game as he looks to throw. Bryant with a catch right side. And he'll lose yardage here, going down back at the 28. And counting the defense here, the Redskins have six defensive backs out there. Back to throw. Goes underneath for Bell. And he's going to have a first down here as he gets this one to the 17-yard line. And now the passing game here in the second quarter starting to heat up a little bit.
Don't you feel the rhythm starting to happen, right? You see it. Now the confidence is starting to rise. I think now as a play caller, because that has happened, you lean on it a little bit more. You don't go totally away from running the football, but you do say, guess what? We can throw it. We can throw it well with a whole lot of confidence.
Tackle made by Perry Riley.
That's a good play by the guys on the defensive side of the ball. Held him to a gain of two. And that changes the playbook a little bit now for the guy calling plays. Second and eight. Now he's got to probably think about going to the air instead of maybe staying with the ground game.
Eighth play of the drive forthcoming, and they need 8 yards on third down.
Here we go now.
Now they'll throw here out of the gun. That's complete right around the eight. And he's able to pick up the first before he's brought down inside the five at the four.
But give the defensive guys a little bit of credit. They didn't let the deep ball beat them on that play, did they?
No, the drag, that guy can be your safety valve. We saw it right there.
Yeah, and they picked up a first down for him, too.
The NFL's second leading rusher last year. This is Doug Martin. It's a gain of a yard, and it'll set up second and goal. Looking at this now, you got a couple more cracks here. This close, sneak it.
I don't think you even go into a huddle. Just line up, snap it, and fall in behind those guys into the end zone.
They come up in an offset eye. And he's going to go down just outside of the five, right around the 6-yard line. Perry Riley able to get him for a loss of about three. So backed up to the 6 now, third and goal.
But this defensive unit certainly picked a great time to make a stand. Back-to-back sacks, starting with first and goal. Have to believe that they'll continue to bring the pressure on third down.
He was looking to hit his running back, Le'Veon Bell, that time. And it's fourth down.
After all the preparation, all the practice, a play like that will absolutely break your heart. They had everything they wanted, just unable to complete it. In the end zone, a big-time drop.
So they get three. They were hoping for six, an unlucky number 13 play drive.
Well, you go to the sideline after putting 3 points on the board, happy, but you wanted to be ecstatic. You wanted to have six on the board. On the opposite sideline, though, the defense, I think they're high-fiving each other, only giving up three after letting them run that much offense.
Well, look at Washington as they come onto the field. And that last drive, a long drive, but not just that. They had a great air attack going. Do they stick with that?
I would think that they would, because if they were confident enough to do it on the last drive, starting backed up in their own territory, why would you change anything? They've got to be confident about what they're presenting and continue to do so.
Yeah, because the secondary, they really look clueless.
And that was amazing because that drive went and went, no adjustments, and no big plays by the defense to knock the ball away.
Davis now. And seeing nowhere to throw, he chucks this one away from harm. Incomplete. Now it's third down.
Whether they deserve credit or not, the defense is going to take credit for that incompletion because it always feels good when you slow down an offense.
On third and short, they'll try and pick it up through the air. And he couldn't hang on to it through the contact. Incomplete.
That was a classic example of trying to run with the ball without securing the catch. He was thinking about those rack yards instead of making the catch first and then taking off.
He steps into this one, and this is a rocket. Oh, he'll field it in the end zone. What a spin. 34 yards on the return, but for a moment looked like he had a shot to go all the way. And the offense will come back onto the field for the first and 10. Pittsburgh's offense now heading back out onto the field. And last time they got 3 points, but it was a chip shot field goal. And when you go to the sideline after a chip shot field goal, maybe the offense not too happy.
It's a balancing act, isn't it? Because you're exactly right. They're none too pleased that they didn't punch it in for 6 points. But they also have to remember, they did put points on the board.
3 points is 3 points.
And in this league, you take points when you can get them. Not easily done.
We always talk about having to read defenses and how complicated that is. Well, this was an excellent read. Read the pressure and got rid of the football before it even got to him for a nice game.
And when they're blitzing like that, running back usually a good spot to go with the football?
Without a doubt, because he's right in your sight line or he's near you. So you're able to just get it to him easily. And once he gets in space, that's usually a good matchup for him.
More now. He's going to sling this deep downfield. And at the 7-yard line, the catch is made. And into the end zone. Touchdown, Pittsburgh. Antonio Brown, 42 yards. And the Steelers are going to add on to their lead. And I think I saw that right. You tell me if I'm wrong. That was just a fly route, just a go. He went.
Sometimes speed, just pure speed, is going to win. I don't care how athletic you are on the other side of the ball. When a guy's that fast and he can just take off, if a quarterback has time to throw the ball and release it when he wants to, that's the end result. Nothing you could do about that. He was just a better athlete on that play.
Here's the Steelers kick team as they'll boot this one away. This is taken at his 4. So quick on the spin.
He's spinning, man.
And he'll be brought down at the 23, make it the 24-yard line. The Redskins offense now, they get set to take over here. And they're coming off a 3-and-out, my friend.
I think they've got to look at that play sheet and go to a spot that they haven't gone before. Time to shake things up a little bit to try and get this offense moving.
Okay, so how do you do that? How do you shake things up?
You look at what you called before, realize it hasn't worked
so well. Go to something else.
And maybe try and find one of those special plays from one of your better players, and maybe try and hit something big and get things going in the excitement area.
A reminder coming up at this and every halftime this season, we'll be checking in with Larry Ridley in Orlando for highlights and analysis of our first half.
LR, that's my man.
That's your guy. Dachson with a grab over the middle. A good pickup there, 22. And now a first down following that long gain. And they're going to hurry back to the line now. Back to throw now on first down. And seeing no options, he just tosses this one away incomplete. Now that'll bring up second down.
It's a tried and true formula, and I don't think it'll change for as long as we play football.
If someone's trying to throw the ball and you can put pressure on them and make it tough, that's only going to help your defense.
Yeah, he's since being hurried. He got rid of it before taking the hit, but incomplete. And he's just going to get rid of this thing to no one here. He throws it away, and now it's third. It looked like he might have had a window there, but the rhythm was just a little bit off.
Certainly was, because everything that has to come together to get a pass completed. Yeah, you're right. The sink just wasn't there.
Davis fighting. He loses the football, and it's picked up by the Steelers. And the return comes to a halt right at the 44-yard line.
The psychology of the game never ceases to amaze me, because you would think there would never be a fumble from what we hear from coaches all the time, right?
And how much they practice not fumbling.
Practice it, preach it, talk about it all the time. You would think no one would ever turn it over. Yet they are humans out there running around, and we just saw another one.
Opportunistic by the defense. And now we get a look at the captain of this offense heading back out there now. And he's been good. Two first-half touchdown passes, no interceptions so far.
Does a lot for your confidence, does a great deal for your team, gives them a lead, and they're feeling really good about how they're playing. I think he expects to throw at least another one.
I was going to say, now he wants the first half hat trick, doesn't he?
Oh, without a doubt. Go ahead and fling him on the field, folks. He wants that type of celebration.
Brown, the lone receiver left.
Green, 39.
Now a play fake here on first down. Over the middle here to Brown. And he's brought down, but not before reaching the 8-yard line. 23 yards on the play. A good grab there by the former Central Michigan man, Antonio Brown.
And he ate up some real estate on the catch too, didn't he? I think the most impressive part of it, though, if there's a chance for him to get the football, even though he was covered well, he somehow finds a way to get it.
Second down here after the incomplete pass.
Really nice play by the guys on the defensive side of the ball, but for the guys on the offensive line, they're doing a nice job of trying to protect their passer. But when a guy hops in the air and goes airborne to try and knock one away, it's difficult because you can't reach out and grab him. That'll be a holding penalty. So all you're trying to do is make some type of a play on him, make some type of contact to try and get his arms out of the sky.
Now Moore. And a quick throw here. That's complete. And now we're going to get a timeout called by the Redskin defense. It's just their first, so they'll have two remaining here before we get to halftime. And the D looking like they may blitz. And no move to take the offense on the field. They're going to stay out there and go for it on fourth and goal. To throw again. Steps away to his left. And he's in for six and a Steeler touchdown. Kellen Moore, as the first half is winding down. And the Steelers find a way to stretch their lead.
Heard a coach talk about those late in the half scores, especially ones that give your team a pretty decent cushion. He said those could be the ones that could finish off a squad if you let them.
Yeah, they've got the cushion. This half has been theirs. And that'll make this a three-score game as the lead moves to 17. Here's the Steelers' kick team as they'll boot this one away. This one taken from the 7. And not a bad return here. He gets it out to the 25-yard line. Now here's the signal caller getting ready to lead this offense again. And how does he rally the troops, so to speak? He's played well, but they're down big on the scoreboard. How does he get his guys going?
To make sure they understand it's not a me game, it's a team game. Everyone has to come together. Everyone has to up the level of play a little bit, including himself, and find a way to make some plays in order to give them a little bit of a spark and rally the team.
We'll see if they can indeed rally down big on the scoreboard right now. And he will lose yardage and be backed up to the 24. So we reach halftime here at our first Monday Nighter of the season, as we'll send you down the coast to Orlando, where we check in with our friend Larry Ridley and the EA.
Thanks, Brandon. Thanks, Charles. And welcome to our EA Halftime Report. I'm Larry Ridley. The Redskins are behind right now, but...
And apparently that's all, Larry. So much for the halftime report. We'll see you in the postgame. We're ready to get to the third quarter. Both teams appear ready for the fight ahead, and we resume action here in quarter number three. This one fielded at the five. And he'll take this across the 25. Couple extra yards up to the 27-yard line. And here come the Redskins now. They have the ball here for the inaugural drive of the second half. Pretty big deficit, though. We'll see what adjustments were made in that locker room.
And I never want to make something more important than it actually is, right? I don't want to create more hype than what is there.
But this
is
a
I'm doing it, though. This is a really important drive. And we often talk about teams scripting plays to start a game. A lot of them script to start the second half, too. And they're scripting something that they expect to get them into the end zone and back into this game.
We'll see if that script is a good one for them. And seeing nowhere to throw, he chucks this one away from harm. Incomplete. Now it's third down. Third down, he'll drop to throw. And incomplete. The contact made the ball roam free and brings up fourth down.
Even in today's NFL, when we think of the tight end position now as really a glorified wide receiver, we're still asking a lot of those guys. They have to block as well, and every now and then, they don't come down with the football.
And he gets this away, and look at this. This is a good one. Now this is fielded in the end zone. Oh, a little 360.
Oh,
so a change of possession here on the punt. And the Steelers will go on offense here, first and 10. Time for the Steelers offense now to get set for their first possession of half number two. They were able to get the ball back here, didn't surrender any points. Now they'll look to add to that lead.
Hey, how about the boost the defense gave them? Going right out on the field, shutting them down, not giving up any points, and turning the ball back over. They want to do their part now and show them a little respect and some gratitude by scoring some points.
And to get a little more cushion.
The best defensive linemen, they play with great leverage so they can get low and not get bowled over by offensive linemen. They have excellent hands. They can throw people off on a play.
And that's caught inside the 35. It's a big play there for the Steelers. 43 yards. Well, we know he's got the speed there. He needed the speed and the hands. A great catch.
And because of that speed, you have to respect it as a defender. So you have to either play off or make sure you're somehow in contact with him. And he's able to do exactly what you said. Use the speed to his advantage and go up and get the football. That's a big-time play right there. Looked like the defense put pretty good pressure on him, but he's able to flush out to his right to try and evade people. On the run, had to get on his horse. Still accurately throws a nice pass for a first down.
And he's in. Touchdown, Steelers. Antonio Brown, already his second touchdown here in this opening weekend. And the Steelers are going to add on to their lead.
In order to lead in a game, you're going to get plenty of contributors. But that's his second touchdown catch of this game. He's one of the key guys in this one.
And you better believe he'll be looking for the hat trick here as this one continues to go. The kickoff team on the field now as they will send this one away. This one taken from the seven. Comes a Redskin offense now as they get set to begin another possession. And down on the scoreboard, certainly needing to avoid what happened on the last drive, punting the football.
Sense of urgency has to take over for them here. They know the score. They know the situation. And by the way, the punter no longer exists for their offense. That's how they have to treat this drive.
They need points.
Big time. No gain on that run, and while this team is down, they're not out of it by any stretch of the imagination. Maybe you just have to think about different style of running in order to get this guy going.
They'll run it with Jones, and he's able to plow forward up to about the 29, just shy of the 30.
Well, there's an example of patience being rewarded. Ran the first down and got stuffed, most people would scream, throw the ball here in this situation. They stayed with their roots, stayed with running the football, and they got rewarded.
He'll drop to throw. This is caught by Jackson. They get 9 yards there, and they get a first down.
Slant route's effective no matter who's running the route and catching the ball. But when you have a receiver of that stature, you have to be a little bit more precise throwing it. You don't have the same catch radius with the bigger targets.
Now a first down carry by Jones. Yeah, that play is blown up, losing yardage back at the 35. A loss of a full 3 yards, and now it's second down. Second down and a little ways to go here, second and 13.
I saw Von Miller in college at Texas A&M, and all I kept hearing about was his speed off the edge to the quarterback. But what impressed me, his balance and his ability to take on blocks and be a force in the run game, as we just saw there.
Just a yard there, so it brings up a tough third and 12. And this defense looks for one more stop here on third after the run.
Well, you know that old expression, it's not my night? It hasn't been his so far. I don't know if the legs are a little bit heavy. Sometimes having to hang out all day and play doesn't exactly play to your advantage, but it's been a tough go for him.
And every time he looks up, somebody's there defensively. That was the same case on that play.
They didn't get the first down, but I have to say I do like the call. I like what they were trying to do. Try and hit your receiver on the run and see if he can pick it up. Keep it on his feet, get a little rack yardage.
Yeah, but a nice job defensively to get to him and keep him short of the first. And this will depend on the spot as it sails out of bounds. And they'll say it sailed out at the 10-yard line. And Pittsburgh getting set to take the field. And they will simply, Charles, be looking to duplicate what they did last drive when they were able to push it in for six.
And they hope it'll be that easy, right? To be able to take exactly what happened before, replicate it. They may have to make a few additional changes along the way because I'm sure the defense will make some adjustments, but they've got to have great confidence having scored the last time out.
From deep in their own territory, they look to throw. Out to the flat, that's complete to his running back. They'll wind up losing three. And now it's third down. And the Redskins have an extra man in the secondary here on third. Moore now. Being chased out left. Wide open receiver complete. They call it a gain of 19, and it moves the chains. He's such a good route runner, shows it there on third down, very proficient and a good pass.
And you know what I've observed over the years in the NFL? The better a route runner you are, the more confidence your guy's going to have in you to go to you in important times because he can trust you being in the right spot, and they connected there and picked up a first down.
Just a yard on the pickup there, and it'll bring up a second and 9. And after the play on the ground, that brings up second down here.
You know how we get focused at end of the half and end of the game situations about how much time's on the board and, you know, what you need to do? Sometimes you don't even have to worry about that. That's just smart football. You know, that kind of a lead, staying in bounds, it burns clock, even in a situation.
Back now at FedEx Field.